a sense of drawing yourself down to your feet, feeling your feet on the earth. As you breathe out, feeling both sit bones and balance between both sit bones. Feeling your tailbone draw down towards the earth. Allowing your knees to descend. And then as you inhale, feeling your spine start to lengthen. Back of the skull lifting. A spreading across your shoulder blades. Becoming aware of your inhalation and your exhalation. The inhalation extends, expands, especially the spine. The exhalation allows you to root a little bit deeper into the earth. These two energies work in tandem with each other. The upward flow of energy and the downward flow of energy. And just imagining for a moment that you're sitting in a pool of moonlight. So under a big full moon. So we have Agni, which is our fire, our internal fire. And this facilitates, helps us to facilitate change. So if you think about what fire is, so it changes the composition of whatever is put into it. And so this change helps us to evolve ourselves. That if we have too much change, if we force too much to happen too quickly, we can burn out. So the opposite is Soma, which is like the coolness of the moon. This is nourishing, it's a sense of being at peace. But if we have too much Soma, or we become complacent and we don't want to change. So it's playing around this edge of it's finding balance between the fire and the moonlight, as it were. The fire of the sun and the cooling energy of the moon. Just bringing the palms of the hands together without losing the length. And I'll just chant, if you know the chant, then you can join in. This is Om Asatoma. So may I be taken from darkness to light. May I be taken from untruth to truth. May I be taken from poison to nectar. So exhaling the breath. Inhaling together. Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityoma Namritamgamaya Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityoma Namritamgamaya Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityoma Namritamgamaya And together. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. I'm just bowing the head to the fingertips. And gently lifting the head. Feet are coming off of your blocks or whatever you're sitting on. And then just crossing the legs the opposite way. And then pulling the flesh back away from the sit bones and just extending the fingertips forwards. So if you have bricks, you're welcome to put the hands on bricks to help. Or you can be up onto fingertips. So you're trying to lengthen your sternum, your heart, forwards along the earth, sliding the shoulder blades down your back. So it's a sense of softening. Then slowly walking the hands back towards you, then crossing the legs the opposite way. Again, flexing through the feet, lengthening the spine, so you're trying to create as much space around your belly area as you can, and then hinging from the hips as you come forwards, and again, either up onto fingertips, or if you have some kind of equipment or books, extending the arms out. So think less about how much can you drop the head down to the ground and more how much can you extend. So try and soften the shoulder blades on the back of the body. And becoming aware as you inhale, it's almost like you inhale and expand on the back of the body. As you exhale, can you extend a little bit further? And walking the hands back towards you. And then from here, coming over on your hands and knees. So spreading the fingers on the ground, pushing down through the shins. And as you inhale, moving from the tailbone through to the crown of the head, as you spread your collarbones. As you exhale, rounding through your upper back, drawing the navel back towards the spine. Inhale, lengthening on the underside of the body. As you exhale, rounding, bowing through the head, pushing up in between the shoulder blades. And again, moving from tailbone to crown of head. As you inhale, and as you exhale, rounding. Couple more. Try and really push your shins into the ground. And then just coming to a neutral back. Moving the hands forward slightly, tuck the toes under, push back, downward facing dog. And then from here, bend the knees slightly and really use your hands to try and push yourself, your belly towards your thighs. You're trying to get as much space and length as you can. And then start to straighten both legs. And again, bend both knees. Try and push against the earth to draw yourself back a little bit more. The sit bones are going back and up. And then straighten both legs. And one last one. Bending. And straightening. And then coming down onto the knees. So we're going to flip over onto your back. Okay, and if you have a strap, that would be great. Or a scarf or something like that. That would work. Okay. And then, so lying down on the back, finding your strap, and then lifting the right leg up into place, the strap over the ball of the foot, and then really try and make sure that the hips are in the same place. So what tends to happen is this wakes up, so we shorten on this side of the body. So can you draw this outer hip down so the sit bones, right sit bones drawing towards the end of the mat. And then holding onto your strap with straight arms, as you inhale, lengthen the heel towards the sky. As you exhale, allow the leg to draw a little closer towards you. Inhale, lengthen, exhale. But try not to bend the knee. So be very aware of whether your leg is straight or not. And you're engaging the muscles from the shin through to the knee, through to the quads. As you inhale, you lengthen through the heel. As you exhale, the leg comes a little closer. And then slowly extending the opposite leg out along the ground. You want to engage the muscles on both legs. I'm just going to sit up and have a quick look at everyone. Really push front of thigh to back of thigh. And especially that, the leg on the ground, can you push down on that one a little bit more too? Okay, and then from here, you're going to hold on to the strap. You're going to bend the right knee a little bit, okay? And you're going to rotate this thigh out. So it's like the knee wants to turn out to the right a little bit more. And then use your left hand on your left pelvic bone. And then you're going to start to extend the knee out to the side, but do not roll over onto the right side. So you want to keep equal balance through the back of the pelvis. And then you can start to straighten that leg. So one way to help you from not rolling onto the right side is to turn the navel to the left. Turn the heart to the left. Keep trying to anchor down as much weight as you can into the left side as you allow the right leg to draw back behind you as well as out to the side. Keep the muscles on both legs very active. If you're finding it too hard to keep the weight on that right side, you can bend the left knee and take the left leg over to the left foot to the left side of your mat, which will help counterbalance a little. And lifting right leg up, now extending both legs along the ground, and just being aware of how one side feels to the other. Then bending both knees, and then lifting the left leg up, extending through the leg, heel lifts, arms are straight. And remember, trying to draw your left sit bone more towards the front of your mat. As you draw the leg a little closer on the exhale. I'm just going to have a check on how you're all doing. Okay, push front of thigh to back of thigh. And then see if you can straighten the opposite leg out. So maybe you're engaging the muscles on both legs. Helen, straighten that leg a little bit more. That's it. Okay, and then from here, you're going to start to take the leg out to the side. So remember that you're moving the strap, or moving the hand up the strap. If you need to, you can bend the right leg now and take the right foot towards the edge of your mat. And then you're externally rotating that left leg and then taking it out to the side. And it's coming, so you don't want the leg down towards the bottom end of your mat. You actually want to draw it as if you were taking it up towards your shoulder. And this is dependent on obviously the flexibility of your hamstrings as well as the inner part of your leg. Let me just have a look at you all. As much as you can, straighten that leg. So push front of thigh to back of thigh. And you're turning your navel to the right. So you're trying to get as much weight into the right side of the body as you can. Okay. And release. And then straighten both legs along the ground. And just notice. So in now this cool, receptive, inward place, notice what has happened to your body. And then from here, just bending both knees, and you're going to gather the knees in towards you, and then hold around the knees. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, draw the nose towards the knees. Inhale to lower. Exhale, nose to the knees. Inhale to lower. And then bring the feet onto the ground. And then we're going to roll all the way up. Okay. And then rolling over the feet, coming back into downward facing dog, and just noticing any difference here. So hands are slightly forwards of the shoulders, tuck the toes under, push back downward facing dog, bend both knees, and try and draw your belly towards your thighs. You're trying to get as much length as you can through your spine. And straighten then both legs. And again, bend both knees, belly to thighs. Lengthen your spine. And straighten both legs. And again. And then looking forwards towards the hands. So you're stepping the right foot forwards in between the hands. So you can either step it all the way through if you can get there, or come down onto the knees first and then step the foot forwards. Okay? If you have bricks, grab a brick. If not, books work, or just fingertips. Okay? You can have the bricks as high as you need, depending on your hamstrings. So you're going to look forward, spread the collarbones. You're looking at this nice long sweep of the back leg. And then as you exhale, rocking back. Inhale, forward, spread the collarbones. Exhale back. Inhale, forwards. Exhale back. So just hold it back for a moment. You're trying to take your hands as far forwards as you can go, but at the same time trying to keep this leg straight. So you're pulling up through your shins, your knees, your quads. So what the moon teaches us is duality. If you think of the phases of the moon from the bright full moon to the dark side of the moon, yin and yang, with the moon and the sun, the receptive qualities of the moon as opposed to the go-getting, the outward of the sun. Inhale, come forwards. Okay, and then from here, I want you to breathe in, lifting the arms up. Can you back it off a little bit? Can you take your tailbone down or the sit bones down, back of the pelvis down, front of the pelvis up? So one's going down, one's coming up. And then sink a little lower into that front leg. We're going to lift the arms up, extend, and then as you exhale, bring the hands towards the heart. Inhale, circling the arms up. Exhale to the heart. And again, inhale. Exhale. Placing the hands on the ground, step back down the dog. And again, this sense of what has happened in your body, one side to the other. Looking forwards towards the hands, either coming down onto the knees first or stepping the left foot all the way through. Nice long lunge. You're aiming your knee towards the back end of your mat. And then either hands onto bricks or fingertips on the earth, depending on what you have available. And then same oscillation. You're spreading your collarbones, lengthening through the front of the body as you inhale. As you exhale, you're rocking back. Inhale forward, spread the collarbones. Exhale back. Inhale forwards, exhale back. Then holding it back here, and just exploring this leg. How does this one feel in comparison to the other? So it's this inward journey. The relationship between your foot and your knee, for instance, is your foot spinning to the inside or the outside? So what is the angle of your foot and how does that relate then to what your knee is doing and your hip? And can you discover what that does on the inside as well as the outside? And then coming forwards. And then sinking the way into this front leg, but at the same time, you're turning your tailbone down the front of the pelvis up. So you're challenging the back hip flexors. Inhale, lifting the arms up. Extend your spine. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, rising. Exhale to the heart. And again, inhale, sink low in that front leg. Exhale. And bringing the hands to the ground, stepping back again, downward facing dog. And again, noticing what has happened in your body from those doing both sides. Does it feel more symmetrical now? Slowly walking the feet towards the hands. And then separating the feet almost as wide as your mat. You can bend the knees slightly so you drape down over your thighs as much as you're able to. And then try and tilt the sit bones up. So we're not sort of sitting, rather than having sort of a, almost like a horizontal line with the thighs, you're trying to almost like tip up as much as you're able to. And then holding on to alternate elbows, just allow the spine to cascade down. There's no effort here. Try and draw the elbows more. It's a Diane Stanley. I was just looking at you all. Try and draw the elbows more towards the front end of your mat. And then change the clasp on the elbows. Taking the elbows towards the front of your mat. Can you lift your sit bones up a little bit more? And now, can you start to straighten your legs as much as you can? But without trying to keep the body connected, if you can, to the legs. And then you're pushing front of thighs, the back of thighs, as much as you're able to. Shifting the weight towards the toes. And then bringing the hands onto the hips. Leading with the heart, coming all the way up, flat back. And then we're going to do a little bit on, so the moon is linked so much to water. If you think of like how the moon changes the tides, and it also has a huge effect on us because we're made up of so much water. So we're going to use a little bit of fluidity here. So you're going to stand to the front of the mat and just going to turn the other way around so you can see what we're doing. So you're going to lift the arms up. Extend the arms. Actually, you can separate the feet a little wider or just under the hips, actually. And then as you breathe out, you're going to bend the knees and drape down over the thighs. So it's like a waterfall. Inhale, gathering the energy up as you rise up and extend the arms up. Exhale, again, bending the knees, draping yourself down over your thighs as you release into a forward bend. And again, breathing in, extending the arms. Exhale, bending the knees, draping yourself down over your thighs. And two more like this. Inhale, lifting, extending, exhale, bending. So thinking of your spine as being completely fluid. Extending and releasing. And then rising up. And we're going to come into a full Chandra Namaskar, so salutation to the moon. So from here, just imagining standing somewhere in moonlight. So the moonlight has the ability to shine in all the dark hidden places. I went out for a walk in the moonlight last night in the forest. And it's amazing how much you can see when the moon is out. So if you use that kind of metaphor with inner sight, we're looking at what we can discover about ourselves on the insides of our body rather than the external. We're going to breathe in, circle the arms, open and up. Exhale, cascade down, so bend the knees. Inhale, halfway. So either up onto fingertips or hands onto shins, extend your spine. And then breathing out, step back, right foot, deep lunge. And then drop the back knee. So we're coming back into that place that we have just visited. Breathing in, lifting the arms up, extending. Exhale. We're going to step back into plank. So nice strong bodies here. Push back through the heels, draw the belly towards the heart. Squeeze the outer hips in and push against the earth. Keep the gaze looking forwards, Nairi. And then drop down onto the knees. And you're going to lower to the ground. And then breathing in, rising up. Cobra, can you take the shoulders up, back, and down? It's like a giant shoulder shrug, up, back, and down. And release down. So resting the forehead for a moment on the earth. So this is the seat of our intuition, the third eye, which is our inner sight. And then pushing up, back through downward facing dog. And looking forwards, you're going to step forwards with the right foot in between the hands. So you can either come down onto both knees and then step forwards and then drop the back knee down. Inhale, circle the arms, open up. Exhale. Stepping forwards into a forward bend. Bend the knees. And then breathe in, lifting all the way up. Exhale to the heart. And again, left side. Breathing in, rising. Looking up towards the moon. Exhale, sorry, cascading down. Bend the knees. Inhale. Straighten the legs, coming up halfway. Exhale, step back with the left leg. Long lunge, drop the back knee. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, stepping back into plank. Strong bodies here, belly towards the heart, pushing back into the heels. Then drop down onto the knees, lower to the ground. As you rise up into Bhujangasana, take the shoulders up, back and down. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Looking forward, step forwards with the left foot. Drop the back knee. Inhale, arms rise. And exhale, stepping forwards to the front of your mat. Inhale, rising up. Exhale to the heart. We're going to see if we can move a little bit more fluidly. Linking more of the movement of your breath with the movement of the body. So just connecting in with the inhalation, which is the upward rising energy, the exhalation, which is the downward rooting energy. Then when you're ready, inhale, circling the arms, open and pop. Exhale, cascading down the front of the body. Inhale, halfway, extend the spine. Exhale, step back, right foot. Drop back knee. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, step back into plank. Inhale here. Exhale to the ground. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right foot forwards. Exhale, drop the back knee. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, forward bend. So slow movements. Inhale, rising. Exhale to your heart. Last one, left side. Breathing in, extending up. And breathing out. Breathing in, halfway. Breathing out, left foot back. Drop the back knee. Breathing in, extending. Breathing out, stepping back into plank. Breathing out, sorry, breathing in. Breathing out, lowering down. Breathing in, cobra. Breathing out, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward dog. Breathing in, left foot forwards, drop the back knee, deep breathe out. Breathing in, lifting up. Breathing out, stepping forwards, forward bend. Breathing in, rising up. And breathing out to the heart. Just standing for a moment in Tadasana, so mountain pose. So you can bring your big toes to touch, arms alongside the body. So feeling down through both feet. What does that feel like from the inside? As you lift your toes, spread your toes, try and fan out through the balls of the feet, from the big toe through to the little toe. And then extending the toes along the earth. And noticing where your weight is in the back heel. It's a sense of being balanced, both right and left side. Notice if there's more weight in one foot than the other, if there's more weight in the outsides or the insides of the feet. And then just pulling up through your shins, pulling your kneecaps up, drawing up through your quads. Having a sense of the bowl of the pelvis. So this is the home of the second chakra, which is linked to the moon and to the water, the element of water. This is like the watery realm of our emotions in here. Also desires. So noticing whether you're ticking one way or the other, and can you have a sense of both front and back of the pelvis drawing towards one another in the center. And then starting to lengthen your ribcage up away from your pelvis to create more space around the waist. And then allowing the shoulder blades to release down your back, spreading across your collarbones. You can feel both shoulder blades sliding apart, back of the skull lifts. So a sense of being both balanced, we think of duality, between the downward rooting energy and the upward lifting energy. Balance between front of the body and the back of the body. and then gently opening the eyes. I'm going to take the legs wide. And a nice wide forward bend. So pushing into the outside edges of the feet. You're going to lengthen the spine. So let's lift the arms up. And then see if you can start to hinge from your hips as you come down towards the ground. And if you need anything to put under the hands, you can grab some, if you've got bricks, otherwise books. Or you might find that you can be on your fingertips here. So it kind of depends on the flexibility of your legs. And then just see if you can take the legs a little bit wider. So you're really challenging yourself. The fingertips are in line with the toes, whether they're on bricks or whether they're on the ground. And then push into the outside edges of your feet. Good. And then pulling up through your insteps, so almost as if you were zipping up through the inner legs. Then inhale, come up halfway, look forward, spread your collarbones. And then exhale, fold down. And then inhale, lift up halfway. Draw your sternum forwards. And release down. Push front of thighs to back of thighs. Last one. Inhale, coming up. Spread your collarbones. Push into the outside edges of your feet. Push front of thighs to back of thighs. And release down. And then from here, can you lift your sit bones up a little bit? And draw yourself down a little bit more. So as much as you lift these sit bones up, it really challenges the hamstrings and that's the knees, but then you're also releasing your spine down. Again, that waterfall analogy, the fluidity through the spine. And then from here, you might want to heel toe the feet in slightly. And then bring the hands onto the hips, straight legs, knees with the heart coming up, flat back. Then just bring the feet together for a moment. Are you all groaning? The thing about having muted you all, I can't hear anything going on. So from here, we're going to take the leg down wide again, but not quite as wide as before. And you're going to turn the heels in, okay? Make sure that the heels are in line with one another, so you haven't got one foot further forward than the other. And then you're going to start to sink low into horse stance. So from here, I want you to turn your pelvis, the front of the pelvis turns up, the tailbone goes down, and you sink low. So it's like you're sitting on a very small horse. And then you can actually round the shoulders here. So see how far you can draw. If you imagine your tailbone being drawn down towards the ground. And then we're going to bring a slight twist into this. But as you exhale, you're going to twist to the right and straighten the left arm. Inhale back to center. Exhale, straighten the other arm, the right arm. Inhale, straighten left. You're twisting. Inhale for center. Exhale, turn. Sink a little bit deeper. Inhale, exhale, turn. Inhale back to center. Exhale, turn again. That's it. So straighten the arm. Last two. So you're straightening to the right elbow is bending, the left arm is straight. Back to center as you inhale. Last one. Sink a little bit lower. Sink, 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 sink.
Some of you I can see are not sinking, although you've even stood up. Who's that at the bottom?
Okay, and then from here, deconstruct the legs. Here on them. And just bring the leg back together.
And then we're going to make our way down to the ground. So we come onto your belly. And then place the forehead on the ground, arms alongside the body. And then separate the feet a little bit. So taking the feet sort of a little bit further towards the edges of your corners of your mat. And then have a sense of your pubic bone drawing down into the ground, like a big root drawing down. And then as you breathe in, you're going to lift the top half of your body off the ground. And extend the arms back. Each time you inhale, see if you can lift a little higher. And again, inhale, lifting. So, locust, shalabhasana. Emma, what are you doing? And release down. Good. And then, so from here, we're going to lift the legs up. But the way we're going to do it is you're going to bring the thumbs into the palms of your hands. You're going to wrap your fingers around your thumb. And then you're going to place your hand right in the fists into the inner groins. Okay? Then lengthen the leg. And then your forehead rests on the ground. And then see how high you can lift your legs. So you're giving a little bit of help to release the hip flexors here by having the fists. Okay. That's it. And can you lift up a little higher? Go on, Nairi, you can do it. Bring the head down to the ground. Lift, 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 lift. And release. Okay, release the hands and then just turn the head to one side. And then turn the head to the opposite side. And release. So, we're going to put that into the whole pose. So, you're going to lift the legs off the ground and then lift the arms. Okay, so it's straight legs, straight arms. And then lifting up as high as you can come. Palms face up. As you inhale, see if you can lift a little higher. Jill, you seem to have given up. And as you exhale, release down. Turn the head to one side. And you do that one more time. Okay, ready everyone? So, forehead rests on the ground. And then deep breath in and lift. Lifting, 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 lifting. Each inhale, you lift a little bit higher. Keep the breath soft and fluid. And release. Well done. Turn the head to one side, just relax. And turn the head to the opposite side.
Okay.
bringing the hands under the shoulders. You're going to push back onto all fours. And we're going to come into a twist. So you may want something to sit on. Just coming into a comfortable cross-legged. Actually, we're not going to do that. You're going to straighten your right leg out. And then bend the left knee. We're just drawing the foot in towards the heels in line of your sit bone. And inhale, lifting the arms up. Send. And then as you exhale, you're going to turn towards the left. Turning the navel towards the left. Inhale, lengthen, extend. Exhale, turn the navel to the left. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, turn the navel to the left. And then taking the right hand back, left hand back behind you. And then just hugging the right knee, left knee in. Keep the leg through the spine. Each time you exhale, can you allow yourself to turn a little bit more? Keep the chin in line with the sternum. It's very easy to think that we're doing this huge twist and all we're doing is turning the head. That's the most flexible part of our spine. And release. Straighten both legs out. And then just bringing the right knee in. Or the right foot, the right knee bent, left leg straight. Inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, start to turn to the right. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, turn. You're using your muscles here to turn the rib cage. Eventually taking right hand behind you and then just hugging the left knee in. So keeping the spine as long as you can. Each time you exhale, allow a softening. It's like you're exploring yourself on the inside in this shape. And release. And then coming off of whatever you're sitting on, and just bringing the soles of the feet together, walking the heels in as close as you can. And then you can use the elbows to encourage the knees to descend a little. At the same time, lengthening the front line of the body. So from the inside, from the pelvic floor all the way up through to the heart. So imagining a golden line. And that is extending. And at the same time, you're drawing your sternum, your heart forwards. Shoulder blades are drawing down the back. This encouragement of the knees to gradually descend, to let go. Cool, receptive energy of the moon, encouraging inner reflection. And gently, and then just closing the knees, and then we're going to swivel back onto all fours, and then coming into pigeon pose. So you're going to bring the right knee behind the right wrist, or to the right side of your mat, and you're going to angle it by showing the other way around. Comes through like this. Here we go. Okay. So this knee is not here in the center. You want to take it right over to the edge of your mat. And then, depending on the flexibility of your hip joint, you can either have the front shin kind of almost horizontal to the front of your mat, or allow it to come back so that as you come down, the heel resting in the groin, so anywhere between those two planes. The important thing here is that you don't drop onto, if I show you from the other side, you don't drop onto this hip. So you don't want to be sitting on this hip. So if necessary, put something underneath. Okay, so you might have something under here that you can sit on, okay, if you're not on the ground. And then just look through to the back foot. Is it sort of doing a funny angle, or is it straight? And then you can either stay here, that's it, or you can start to release down. You can come down onto the elbows. You're trying to draw your right sit bone back and the left front hip forward. So you're trying to square your hips to the front of the mat, as well as keeping them horizontal to the earth. So you might be happy here, or you might find that you can come down to the ground. You can rest one hand on top of the other, or you can stretch the arms out in front of you, resting the forehead on the ground. And I just want you to focus on your breathing here. So, finding your inhalation and your exhalation. There's two streams of breath coming in through each nostril. And they converge at that point in between the eyebrows, at the sort of just above the bridge of the nose. When you're exhaling from that point, two streams of breath coming out through each nostril. And just exploring, just being aware of whether your inhale is slightly longer than your exhale or vice versa. Does one nostril feel more dominant than the other?
that you feel more of an ease of flow of air through, this one side feels slightly blocked. And just letting go of the observation of your breathing. Slowly walk the hands back towards you.
And lift up, lengthen the spine again. And then pushing back downward facing dog. You're tucking the back toes under and pushing back downward facing dog.
And then either coming down onto the knees first in order to transition, or just bringing the left knee all the way through behind the left wrist. Then extending the other leg back. Remember, you want to try and draw this front hip forwards and the back, the left sit bone back. So your hips are level to the front of the mat. And then using something if you need it to stop you rolling onto that hip, so you don't want to end up looking like that. Yeah, you actually want to be level. You might stay here, or you might find that you can come down onto the elbows. Or you might find that you can come all the way down towards the ground, either placing one hand on top of the other, forehead or hands, or stretching the arms out in front of you. So either any of those variations work. And again, bringing your awareness to your breathing. The two streams of breath coming in through each nostril. And converging just above the bridge of the nose. Two streams of breath coming out. To a point just in front of the tip of the nose. And then releasing the breath. And sliding the hands back in, lengthening the spine. And then tucking the toes, back toes under. And just transitioning back into downward facing dog. And then coming down onto the knees, sink the sit bones back onto the heels, coming into extended child. And gently lifting. So, then we come into Shavasana for our yoga nidra. So if you gather together whatever you need, sort of a block or a blanket or a cushion for under your head, something up over you if you think you're going to get chill, and just finding whatever you need. When you're ready, just lying down. So take time to come into Shavasana, lengthening through the back of the neck, the shoulder blades down the back. Making sure that the back of the pelvis is equally balanced. So just taking the last few moments to adjust the body so that it's comfortable and you don't need to move again. So for those of you who are not familiar with yoga nidra, this is a practice of yogic sleep with a trace of awareness. So the body in effect sleeps, the mind sleeps, and awareness observes. Awareness stays present. So just acknowledging to yourself that you are about to embark on the practice of yoga nidra, and that you will stay conscious throughout the whole practice. Just bringing your awareness back to your breathing. So you inhale and exhale. So you inhale, there's a slight rise of the navel. As you exhale, gentle fall of the navel. So you inhale, the abdomen rises, as you exhale, it pulls back towards the spine. There's virtually no movement in the upper chest. This is that gentle, very gentle abdominal breathing in the rise and fall of your abdomen. And just refining your breathing so the exchange of the breath becomes smoother and smoother. Then you're going to begin to count down with your breath from 10 to 0. So as you exhale 10. Exhale 9. Exhale 8. The closer you get to 0, the more the mind and body become established in a place of peace and stillness. At 0, find that you're resting in a place of absolute peace. With no trying, just be relaxation. Bringing your awareness now to the center of your third eye, so the area in between the eyebrows, just back and slightly up into the midbrain. And sensing, picturing, imagining bright white light, like starlight, in the center of your midbrain. No effort, no trying, just relaxation. And observing our awareness, this bright starlight in the center of your brain. Bringing your awareness now to your throat. Sensing, picturing, no effort, bright star at the center of your throat. Bringing your awareness to your right shoulder, the center of your shoulder, bright white light. Bright light, the center of your right elbow, and bright wrist. Points of light, tip of your left, sorry, right thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger, fourth finger. No effort, no trying, just deep relaxation. Being aware, point of light at the center of your right wrist, right elbow, right shoulder. Find a starlight, the center of your throat. Bright white light, center of your left shoulder. Left elbow and left wrist. Train of stars, tip of your left thumb. First finger, second finger, third finger, fourth finger. Point of light. Center of your left wrist, left elbow, and left shoulder. Point of light at the center of your throat. Bright starlight, the center of your heart, behind your sternum. Bright starlight is behind the navel towards the spine. point of light, the center of your pelvis, in front of your sacrum. Bright starlight, center of your right hip. Right knee, no effort, just relaxation. Sensing a bright star at the center of your right ankle, tip of your right big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe. Right star at the center of your right ankle, right knee, right hip. No effort. Right star at the center of your pelvis. Right starlight, the center of your left hip. Left knee. Right star, the center of your left ankle. Trail of stars, tip of your left big toe. Second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe. Right starlight, center of your left ankle, left knee, left hip. Right star, the center of the pelvis. Another at the center of your belly, just behind the navel. Bright starlight, the center of your heart, center of your throat, center of your third eye, midbrain. Imagining, sensing all these points of light at once. As if you were looking up to a dark night sky under this luminous big moon and seeing the constellation of stars, and seeing all these points of light at once. No trying, just relaxation. An awareness of the points of light, like the constellation of stars. Then bringing your awareness to the space in between the starlight. Space in between each point of light. Now bringing your awareness back to your breathing and sensing the two streams of breath that you were noticing earlier. Two streams of breath come in through each nostril, converging at the midbrain with the third eye. Two streams of breath come out of each nostril, converging to a point just beyond the tip of the nose. So just establish your awareness on these two streams of breath that rise and fall through each nostril. And the next time you inhale, inhaling through both nostrils and sensing exhaling through the left nostril. Inhaling through the left nostril, exhaling through the right nostril. Inhaling through the right nostril, exhaling through the left nostril, and so on. So no effort, no trying, just awareness of the alternating breath. So finally letting go of the patterning or the observation of the patterning of the breath, allowing the breathing to come back to its normal pattern. And gradually deepening your breath. And when you're ready, bringing some gentle movement to your fingers, toes, wrists, and ankles. There's a poem for you called Estuary. There is peace here, where the river widens to meet the sea. The rapids are past, the boulders and the rocky faces at last give way to a broad and sweeping current, flowing slowly into vastness. The river moves silently, tastes the salty tide that marks its demise, and spits without a backward glance into the ocean's infinite embrace. When you're ready, bending one knee and the other, and you're gathering the knees in towards you. And then rolling over onto your left side and making your way up into sitting. Take a moment to offer deep gratitude to your body for your practice. Thank you very much. Namaste. I would just unmute you all.